Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss the important theorem, Cauchy's inequality. Cauchy's inequality. Suppose that a function f is analytic inside and on a positively oriented circle CR. Positively oriented circle CR centered at Z naught and with radius capital R. If capital MR denotes the maximum value of modulus of f of z on CR, then modulus of nth derivative at z naught is less than or equal to n factorial into capital MR by r to the power of n, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Let us prove this one. What is a given? Let f of z is analytic inside and on CR, where what is CR? CR is positively oriented circle centered at Z naught of radius capital R. That is, modulus of Z minus Z naught is equal to R. A circle at center Z naught of radius capital R in the positive sense. This is CR. Also given that on CR, modulus of all the functional values of F has the maximum value as capital MR. That is, modulus of F of Z is less than or equal to capital MR on CR. Since capital MR is the maximum, then each and every value is less than or equal to the maximum value. By the previous theorem, that is Cauchy's extension theorem for Cauchy's integral formula, what we have, nth derivative at z naught is equal to n factorial by 2 pi iota integration over CR f of z by z minus z naught to the power of n plus 1 dz. Now I want here modulus of this one. So this implies modulus of nth derivative of f of z naught is equal to modulus of n factorial by 2 pi iota integration over CR f of z by z minus z naught to the power of n plus 1 dz. This one can be written as less than or equal to modulus of n factorial is n factorial by 2 pi, modulus of iota is 1, integration over CR, modulus of f of z by modulus of z minus z naught to the power of n plus 1 dz. Modulus of f of z on CR is less than or equal to capital R, capital MR, and this value is equal to R on this one. So what you'll get here, n factorial by 2 pi, this value is less than or equal to capital MR by, this one is R to the power of n plus 1 integration over CR dz, which is equal to n factorial by 2 pi into capital MR by r to the power of n plus 1 into, what is this one? Circumference of a circle. What is the circumference of a circle? That is length of the contour CR. Since it is a circle, length of the contour, that is circumference of a circle, is 2 pi its radius, that is capital R. 2 pi capital R. R, R, 2 pi, 2 pi get cancelled. Then the remaining answer is n factorial capital M R by R to the power of n. Therefore, modulus of nth derivative of the function f of z naught is less than or equal to n factorial capital M R by R to the power of n. This is a Cauchy's inequality. Now let us prove the next important theorem. That is Liouville theorem. If F is entire and bounded in the complex plane, then f of z is constant throughout the plane. As well as the previous theorem and this theorem, both are important. Suppose that f of z is an entire function and as well as bounded. Say modulus of f of z is less than or equal to capital M for all z. Now we have to prove that f of z is constant throughout the plane. Now it is sufficient to prove f dash of z is equal to 0 for all z in the entire complex plane. If the derivative is 0, when the derivative becomes 0, if the given function is a constant function. So let us take any arbitrary point in C, any arbitrary point, and arbitrary radius capital R greater than 0. Consider modulus of z minus z naught is less than or equal to capital R. A circle centered at z naught of radius capital R. Therefore, by the Cauchy's inequality, what you will get? Modulus of first derivative of f of z naught is less than or equal to 1 factorial capital M by R to the power of 1, which is equal to capital M R. Since what is f of z? F of z is an entire function. F of z is an entire function, then I can take the radius as large as possible, and R can be chosen arbitrarily large. So letting R tends to infinity, as R tends to infinity, this one becomes 0, then we get modulus of this one is less than or equal to 0. Modulus of f dash of z naught is equal to 0. Modulus is never negative, so it has only one option. That this implies f dash of z naught is equal to 0. Since z naught is arbitrary, therefore f dash of z is equal to 0 for all z belongs to C. Therefore, f of z is a constant function throughout the plane. Thank you.